Hey everyone. So it's that time I have to mix up a gallon of nutrients for my tomato plant. So I figured I would show you how I do it. So I actually have a gallon of water that I leave out just sitting on the counter. So it's been out probably for 3-4 days. And that's what I use to mix it in. So here's my little scale. I'm using the Masterblend formula. And I'll just show you what I do. So I set that on, I'll give that a tear, and I use a 2-gram master blend, 2.1, it's close enough, not really critical, and I actually have a thing of warm water here. I throw the nutrients in the warm water, and I actually mix it. Dissolve it all up. Once I'm done with that, I'll pour that into the jug and then I'll go on to the next one. I don't like to mix them together. I know you can. I know people say it's fine. I just personally, since I'm mixing a small amount, I like to do it like this. Dissolve it, put it in the jug, and then go to the next one. So I do each one individually. Okay, so I got the first one, which was the Master Blend. I'm going to do the calcium nitrate now. Just pour that in until it gets to right around 2. That's good enough. Pour this into my water. And again, I will stir it up, making sure it all dissolves. I'm actually using a milk jug for my 1 gallon measurement. Works out good. Okay, so that looks good. Pour that into my jug. I rinse out the cup each time. Don't think you have to, but I don't know, that's the way I've always done it. And then we're going to do 1 gram of the Epsom salt. Oh, my scale just went out. That's not good. Pour that back. Gee. Okay. Try this again. 1 gram of the Epsom salt. Whoop. 2 is too much. Gotta pour some of that back. .3, close enough. A little bit extra, I don't think ever hurt anything. I'm never exact on anyway, so. This one takes a little bit longer to actually mix and dissolve. Warm water helps, but it still takes a little bit to dissolve it. Get rid of the sink. You put it in the sink here. So I'll pour this in. So all 3 are in there now and dissolved. So I'll just cap this off and shake it all up. Now I don't normally check the pH. I've checked it a bunch of times in the past. My tap water comes out about 7 or a little over. Once I add the nutrients, that puts it down to about a 6.7 or so, and that's normally pretty good. Every once in a while I'll check it, but not very often, because it seems to be just fine after the nutrients are added. So that's it. Nutrients in a milk jug, 1 gallon. Now I have to go feed my tomato plant. Hopefully this is helpful to some people. Don't forget, if you like the video, please like it, subscribe, share, all that kind of stuff. Okay? Thanks for watching. See ya.